left American Idol to bring his own show, The X Factor, to America. Take a look.
I'm so happy. I'm so happy.
I'm so happy right now. Like, Simon was like my dream judge, you know?
Biggest fear just came over me. I'm going to perform in front of Simon Cowell. I can't mess up.
This is absolutely the category I wanted. Because I know the winner is in this category.
People say that all the time. Am I supposed to feel bad about that?
Not that you're ugly on TV, yeah, but you're very attractive in real life.
Yeah, people say that. No.
And TV doesn't quite tell the real story about your body either.
It doesn't. It doesn't, right?
No, I mean.
But they fit. They fit
yeah,
my.
Yeah, but I mean, seriously, all I'm thinking is, I know this is going to get bleeped, is you're huge. Fantastic.
But they fit my body. Well, I
bet you haven't seen your feet in years.
No, not many years. No. Although my feet are long, so
no, but you still
sit there.
You still wouldn't see them.
Well, let me just say that you are equally as handsome in person as you are on TV. I've always found you to be a very handsome man. And I love people. I find it an attractive quality when people know how to say it like they mean it, but not. Like, I've seen you be very nice to people also,
yes.
So I know that that's not...
I do like people.
Yeah.
Yeah. I know I do. And then other people irritate me.
Gotcha. Well, congratulations on X Factor.
Thank you.
We're loving the show. We love the show here. You know, you were on American Idol for 9 seasons, and it was such a big gamble for you to leave and start this X Factor project. Why did you decide to leave such a successful show like Idol?
I like gambles because I get bored, you know, and I like taking risks. And all my life, you know, it's, you know, nothing should be safe.
Yeah.
And after a while, 8 or 9 years, however long it was time to do something else. I was getting itchy feet, and it was like going on a roller coaster. You know, it's kind of be exciting. You're going to have your ups and downs, but I've honestly had the best time I've had in years. I'm loving it.
Well, we're loving it also. It's worthwhile gamble. Now, you and Randy and Paula had such great chemistry on Idol, and we here on Wendy, remember, it was a big deal during Hot Topics that this Paula thing, leaving Idol, it was a joke. It was a joke. We just knew that she was going to end up staying for that last season.
That's what I thought.
Well, can you take us through it? Did you really think that? Because I thought you'd be able to pull strings, do something.
Wendy, I swear to God, I thought this is a negotiation. I've seen it happen a million times, you know, at the last minute. It's all going to happen, and she's going to be back on the show. And then I got a phone call from one of the guys at Fox to say she isn't. I called Paula, said, how are you? Very calm. She said, Simon, on principle, wasn't going to do it. And it was that night when I said to her, well, the good news is in a couple of years' time, I'm almost certain we're going to bring this other show to America. Because she'd been on the British version as a guest judge.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, just hang in there tight. And that's what happened.
Well, thank goodness she's there with you on X Factor. I love Paula on the show. I think Paula is looking better than ever. You know, look how fabulous Paula looks. Can I ask you something? Because I've always found it very difficult to believe that men and women can be just friends if they've never slept together.
Well, we're friends.
Me and you?
Yeah, we're friends.
But the night is young. No, seriously, you and Paula, was there ever any weirdness there that there might be a dating situation?
Oh, 100%. I once described our relationship, and I use dogs a lot with Paula, but not in the American dog sense, the English dog sense, which is we love dogs. But if I was a can of dog food, she was a starving puppy. So she used to look at me all the time, because like the dog would look at the cat,
right.
The can of dog food.
Yes.
And that was a responsibility.
We think we know where you're going with this one.
No. I always, it crossed my mind, you know, should I? She probably wants to. No. Mainly because afterwards we'd have to talk.
Yes, that could be the problem.
And but, that would be very uncomfortable.
But I like the sexual tension. I like that I can look in magazines and she's sitting in your lap or whatever. It's very adorable.
Yeah.
So now, you say that you met your match in your new fellow judge on X Factor, L.A. Reid.
Mm.
Tell, how so?
Well, L.A. I used to work with years ago when we both worked. He was running Arista Records and I was working for the British label. And he was very cool. He was everything I always thought a record company boss should be like. You know, flash, great offices, cute staff, you know, he walked the walk.
Mm-hmm.
And then when he became my competitor, he was a nightmare. I mean, a serious nightmare. He ran Interscope, he signed Justin Bieber, he signed Rihanna, Mariah Carey. I mean, he's got a big, big track record.
Yeah.
So I thought, it's much better to have him on my side than competing, and he wanted to be on the show. And it's made me raise my game, Wendy, you know? It's good for me.
That was a good pick for you, too. He's very entertaining to watch.
Yeah.
I wasn't sure how he was going to fit in the mix, but he's very entertaining. That was a good pick. Nicole Scherzinger, why her?
Nicole is like, if you were going to draw a cartoon of the most beautiful girl in the world, it wouldn't be far off.
She is
Nicole.
Beautiful.
I mean, she's,
yeah.
I mean, that's not normal.
Yeah, well, she's a beautiful woman.
So she's like,
yes.
She's like Jessica Rabbit.
Yes.
Unfortunately, we put Daffy Duck's brain in.
Oh. So...
But I love Daffy Duck, you know?
Daffy Duck makes good judging.
Ditzy.
Yeah.
You know, she's ditzy.
Yeah, she's entertaining to watch as well.
Yeah, and she's adorable.
Yeah, she is.
And don't forget, she started off in this area. You know, she was found on a... She's going to kill me for the Daffy Duck. She started off on one of these reality shows where she was discovered as a singer. So, and not only that, she's a seriously good singer.
So she knows how to play the game. Well, she's
yeah.
a good pick also. Listen, next we're going to find out why Simon turned down $1 million for one day of work. You keep it here, okay? All right, good.